The Philippines Office of the Chief of Staff, Camp General Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City, 17 January 2013. Office Orders Number 03, Assumption. Pursuant to Section 2, General Orders Number 71, General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, dated 15 January 2013, I hereby assume the duties and responsibilities of Acting Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, effective this date.
We shall now proceed with the turnover of command symbol to be presided by His Excellency Benigno Simeon Aquino III.
The saber symbolizes trustworthiness, steadfastness, and responsibility. This saber signifies military leadership and warfare.
We will now witness the raising of personal flag of the new Chief of Staff, Foreign Forces of the Philippines.
Sergeant Major. Raise my flag.
Personal flag is a distinct symbol of authority, and this signifies that someone is in charge.
Your Excellency requests permission to give tigas painga to the troops. Troop Commander, please give tigas painga.
Tigas! Ha! Kalipunan, tigas.
His Excellency Benigno S. Aquino III, the Commander-in-Chief of all Armed Forces, former President Fidel V. Ramos, Vice President Jejomar Binay, Secretary Voltaire Gasmin and Mrs. Gasmin, Executive Secretary Paquito Ochoa Jr., may also greet cabinet officials present, the Honorable Mar Rojas, DILG, Secretary Ging Deles, Office of the Presidential Assistant on the Peace Process, Commissioner David of the Bureau of Immigration, the Honorable Abaya, DOTC, the Honorable Rosales of the Commission on Human Rights, the Honorable Cortez of the Office of the Presidential Assistant on Military Affairs, Presidential Communications Chief Honorable Coloma, members of the Congress present, former Secretaries of National Defense, former Chiefs of Staff, former Major Service Commanders, members of the Diplomatic Corps and Foreign Armed Forces attachés, the Major Service Commanders, Lieutenant General Lauro de la Cruz and Vice Admiral Jose Luis Alano, the Chief PNP, Police Director General Aran Polisima, the Chief of the Philippine Coast Guard, Rear Admiral Isorena, Commanders of the Unified Commands, members of PMA Class 1981 and their ladies, Members of PMA Class 79 and their ladies. The members of the Philippine Army Multisectoral Advisory Board. Other general and flag officers. Other local executives present. My family, led by my mother Gloria and wife Ditas, my son Paolo, my siblings and other relatives. Visitors from the religious sector and the academe. My former classmates, friends from the media, officers, men, and civilian employees of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I would like to begin with an invocation to God Almighty, thanking Him for this singular opportunity to serve our country and people. His constant divine guidance has always been the source of my strength, and with His grace, I pledge to continue to bring honor to His name. I thank those who have entrusted in me this tremendous responsibility and honor as the Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines. His Excellency Benigno S. Aquino III, President and Commander-in-Chief of all Armed Forces. And the Honorable Voltaire T. Gasmin, Secretary of National Defense. I am humbled and honored by your trust and confidence. To General Jesse D. De Llosa, our outgoing Chief of Staff, on behalf of the entire AFP, our deepest gratitude for fortifying the foundations of our transformation and for leading us with your steadfast dedication to winning the peace. I also extend my heartfelt gratitude to all who have walked with me in this path to our nation's peace and security. My family, my wife Ditas, my son Paolo, and my mother Gloria, my siblings and other relatives, those who have journeyed with me in my 33 years in the service, my mentors and companions in my intellectual pursuits while at the University of the Philippines, the Philippine Military Academy, and high school, my superiors, friends, and colleagues in the armed forces, including and most especially those who have gone before us in service to our nation. I dedicate my service as Chief of Staff, AFP, to all of you. But most of all, I dedicate this final chapter in my military service to my father, the bedrock from where I stand here before you today. He was and always be my inspiration and role model as a soldier for peace. To the Filipino people, I pledge that I shall lead the armed forces of the Philippines pursue two major undertakings, namely the fulfillment of our constitutional mandate and the pursuit of security sector reform initiatives. Our constitution has bestowed on us the distinct title of being the protectors of the people and the state, with the goal of securing the sovereignty of the state and the integrity of the national territory. We intend to fulfill this constitutional mandate through the following thrust: winning the peace, securing our national territory, and assisting in disaster response and rehabilitation. Our internal peace and security plan is working because of the Bayanihan spirit that has been rekindled in all stakeholders. Together as a people, we are closer now in winning the peace, as the AFP takes on a support role in achieving and maintaining peace and security. We see more empowered communities and deepening of democratic institutions, the foundations of a peaceful society. We are inspired by the developments in the peace process with the MILF, the CPLA, and the RPMP-RPA-ABB. The signing of the framework agreement at Dabang Samoro is a national triumph for peace. It is also a giant stride for IPSP Bayanihan. Our active support and adherence to the primacy of the peace process has greatly contributed in the forging of the agreement. We hope that the CPP-NPA-NDF will likewise pursue the road to peace and abandon the armed struggle. As we have long realized, armed struggle is not the solution to our problems. We recognize that the biggest challenge ahead of us is the process of normalization. The details of this are still being discussed by the respective peace panels, but definitely the AFP will be fully supportive of its implementation. The success of IPSP Bayanihan is anchored on the coming together of the entire Filipino nation in the pursuit of peace. We, your soldiers, need your help. Join us in calling for an end to armed violence and in advocating for peace to allow us to focus on the more important task of securing the sovereignty of our state and the integrity of our national territory, as well as protecting our people from the adverse effect of climate change and environmental degradation. As we support the peaceful and diplomatic resolution of territorial issues, we shall endeavor to provide a credible defense posture worthy of the heroism of our forefathers. We need to upgrade our joint and combined operations capabilities to be able to contain any external threats. We shall also continue to contribute in ensuring regional and international peace and stability to global Bayanihan through strengthened and increased bilateral and multilateral engagement with our neighbors and allies. We will endeavor to send more UN peacekeeping forces and develop capabilities to assist other nations in responding to natural calamities, just as our friends and allies have come to our aid in times of disaster. Indeed, in recent years, the effects of climate change have been more adverse than armed conflict. This is an emerging concern that we need to pay serious attention to. Your soldiers have risked their own safety, and some have even laid down their lives to save our people during natural disasters. We shall continue to upgrade our disaster rescue and relief operations capabilities and take part in proactive measures such as environmental protection to mitigate adverse effects of disasters. Of course, we must ensure that the AFP as an organization is capable of performing its mandated tasks. Thus, I will carry out and sustain the security sector reform initiatives that we have already started, focusing on two major agenda: capability development and professionalization. We shall give priority to developing a professional, strong, and fully mission-capable joint force. We will develop our mission essential capabilities in internal security, territorial defense, and disaster rescue and relief operations, as well as build up a robust and reliable reserve force. The most important asset of the AFP is its personnel. Hence, the top consideration in our capability development program is the professionalization of the men and women behind these machines. The competency of the individual soldier must be developed. Each soldier must know his job and perform his job well. Soldiers shall be held to high ethical standards and strict codes of conduct. The trust of the people is vital in the performance of our delicate mandate as protectors of the people and the state. We shall continue to advance the Daang Matuwid of our Commander-in-Chief. We are likewise sworn to protect our democratic institutions and processes. Your AFP shall remain nonpartisan in the upcoming May elections. You can count on us to assist in ensuring honest, credible, orderly, and peaceful elections. Likewise, we cannot but overemphasize adherence to human rights, international humanitarian law, and the rule of law as imperatives in all our military undertakings. We shall harness the support of civil society as well as national and multilateral monitoring bodies in ensuring that these principles are promoted, respected, and protected. In the same token, the morale and motivations of our soldiers are important if we expect them to attain a high level of professionalism. Thus, we shall, among others, improve the health care extended to our soldiers and their dependents, and increase the survivability of our soldiers in the front lines. We shall also ensure and strengthen the implementation of policies for a merit-based promotion system. On our reform initiatives, we adhere to the thrust of the government's security sector reform agenda and focus on promoting good governance and performance excellence. We shall carry on with our various transformation initiatives and ensure that all of these are aligned with the Defense Transformation Roadmap in order to institutionalize and ensure sustainability of these efforts. Let us improve critical systems and processes by optimizing the defense system of management. We shall abide by the tenets of good governance with emphasis on transparency, accountability, fairness, and the observance of human rights, international humanitarian law, and the rule of law. We shall adhere to democratic control and oversight mechanisms. To fully effectively perform our constitutional mandate and undertake our reform initiatives, we need the support and participation of all our stakeholders, both internal and external to the organization. To my fellow soldiers, let us focus on our mandate. Let us be open to changing mindsets and paradigm shifts. Transformation will not happen with a simple snap of a finger. We have to work hard and work together to achieve our common goals and aspirations. To our partners, stakeholders, our bosses, the Filipino people, for you and with your help, we will endeavor to reach our vision of having a world-class armed forces that is a source of national pride. Mabuhay ang sandatahang lakas ng Pilipinas, mabuhay ang sambayan ng Pilipino.
Alipunan, man, go! Mga sampanaw! Go!
We shall now move on with the retirement ceremony. May we request our distinguished honoree, General Jesse D. De Liosa, Armed Forces of the Philippines, to please stand at the center front of the stage for the reading of orders. The retirement order will be read by Brigadier General Rolando G. Hongo, the Adjutant General, Armed Forces of the Philippines.
Republic of the Philippines, Department of National Defense, General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Captain Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. General Orders Number 1005, published on 25 October 2012. Compulsory retirement. Pursuant to Sections 5A and 17 of Presidential Decree Number 1638, as amended, in consonance with the Presidential Administrative Order Number 150, dated 04 January 1990, General Jesse D. De Liosa, Officer DAS 7926, Armed Forces of the Philippines, having completed 37 years, 9 months, and 9 days of active military service in the Armed Forces of the Philippines from 01 April 1975 to 19 January 2013, is compulsory retired in the rank of General with a retirement pay based on the salary grade of General with 5th longevity pay effective 20 January 2013. By order of the Secretary of National Defense, signed Rolando G. Hongo, Brigadier General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, the Adjutant General.
We shall now witness the presentation of command plaque and plaque of honorable service to the honoree. May we request Ma'am Mary Rose De Liosa to please join his husband as he receives the plaques. May we request His Excellency Benigno Simeon Aquino III to present the plaques, assisted by the Honorable Voltaire Tigasin, Secretary of National Defense, and Lieutenant General Noel A. Cobalyes, Vice Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines. The citation of the plaques will be read by the Adjutant General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Brigadier General Rolando G. Hongo. The audience is requested to stand to witness the presentation of plaques.
General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Captain Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Command plaque is presented to General Jesse D. De Liosa, Officer DAS 7926, Armed Forces of the Philippines, in grateful acknowledgement of his eminently meritorious and valuable service rendered us, Chief of Staff, Armed Forces of the Philippines, from 12 December 2011 to 17 January 2013, given the 7th day of January in the year of our Lord, 2013, at General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, General Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City, signed Noel A. Cubalyes, Lieutenant General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vice Chief of Staff. General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Captain Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Plaque of Honorable Service is presented to General Jesse De Liosa, Officer DAS 7926, Armed Forces of the Philippines, in recognition of his 37 years, 9 months, and 19 days of faithful and honorable service rendered to the Armed Forces of the Philippines during the period from 01 April 1975 to 19 January 2013. Given this 7th day of January in the year of our Lord, 2013, at General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Com General Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City, signed Noel A. Cubalyes, Lieutenant General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vice Chief of Staff.
Likewise, a memento will be presented to the outgoing Chief of Staff. The memento is a Philippine flag symbolizing the gratitude for the faithful and honorable service he has rendered to the nation and the Filipino people. The beloved spouse of our honoree, Mrs. Mary Rose F. De Liosa, shall be presented with a plaque of appreciation.
General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Capital Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Plaque of appreciation is presented to Mrs. Mary Rose F. De Liosa in grateful appreciation for her wholehearted and faithful and unselfish support to her husband's successful and devoted service to our nation. Given the 7th day of January in the year of our Lord 2013, on the occasion of the retirement of her husband, General Jesse D. De Liosa, Officer DAS 7926, Armed Forces of the Philippines, General Headquarters, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Com General Emilio Aguinaldo, Quezon City. Signed, Noel A. Cubalyes, Lieutenant General, Armed Forces of the Philippines, Vice Chief of Staff.
A round of applause for the honoree and his spouse. At this point, the Honorable Voltaire T. Gasmin, the Secretary of National Defense, will introduce the guest of honor.
Mga binibini at mga Ginoo, ang punong pangkalahatan ng sandatahang lakas at Pangulo ng Republika ng Pilipinas, kagalang-galang Binigno S. Aquino III.
Mabuhay tayo lahat.
Major General Domingo, please give the troops tigas pa nga.
Tikas! Ha! Ano po yan? Tikas! Ha!
Vice President,